G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Now, I don't know what's going on with Dragon these days, but apparently this kid has been out since about 2014. But I hadn't seen it in any shops in Australia, and I have found that some of the other 1/9 scale Dragon figures in their sort of Marvel or comic range. Very hard to get. Don't really see them even in Australia, in the shops in Australia. So I'm not really sure what Dragon's doing. They seem to bring them out and then they seem to stop making them after a while. And I still think that these kits would still be selling, especially the 1/9 scale stuff, the unpainted versions. You can get a painted version and an unpainted version of the 1/9 scale stuff. But this stuff is just sort of, for me, come and gone. I didn't even really know about it. Apparently, these kits have been out since 2014. And I only really found out about them about last week when I was looking through HobbyLink Japan's website, and I came across them. Now the amazing thing about this is I picked one of these kits up, or a couple of them up, but for around $12.50. So we're talking 1/24th scale, but for $12.50, that is an absolute bargain. I mean, what other kits can you get in 1/24th scale for $12.50? And this is the unpainted version. I don't want the painted version. If I wanted the painted version, I'd just buy a bloody statue or something. So as of the date of posting this video, you can pick this up from HobbyLink Japan or one of these. There are four of them there. You only get one in each kit. But for $12.50 Australian or $12.57 or something like that. Now that is an absolute bargain. I picked up this little fellow here because I actually also wanted the base. And this one here as well, because I quite liked his flying stance. You get another base with him as well, but I quite like this base a little bit better because there's a little bit more to it. This guy's pretty cool as well, but I could only find the painted version of these two. I don't know what's going on with the hobby shops in Australia and Dragon's supply chain or whatever, but I hadn't seen these in the shops in Australia at all. And it's been out since around 2014. Absolute cray cray. I guess we better have a look inside and see what this is all about. And there we have it, guys. Pretty much all the contents to the kit. And there's a little bit under there as well. Just a couple extra little parts. So pretty basic. I wouldn't exactly call it a hard model kit to put together. The arms come in one piece. The arms come in one piece, the legs come in one piece, the head in one piece, so you've just got to put the torso together, the back and the front of it. After pulling it out, it seems to be the torso is made out of some sort of plastic, like you would normally get in a scale model. But the actual legs and arms and the head seem to be made out of some sort of rubbery, maybe PVC type stuff because it doesn't cut like resin does. You can see as I cut into that, it's quite rubbery, some sort of PVC or something like that, vinyl for the heads and arms and legs, but the actual torso is some type of plastic. Now overall, the detail on this is very nice. We are talking 1/24 scale, and we're talking $12.50. $12.50. I mean, come on, guys. $12.50. I couldn't believe it when I saw it for that price. Look at that. Well, obviously, the main join problem is going to be when you're joining the torso together. You're going to get that nice line all the way down the side there that you're going to have to do a bit of tidy up on. And on the vinyl, PVC, rubbery bits, whatever you want to call them, you do get a very fine mold lines on each part. Probably, hopefully, might show up there. Nothing majorly bad, just running down the sides of the arm there, or the front and back if you like, and down the actual legs as well. As I said, it's nothing too drastic. Not too sure if I'll try to attack that with my hobby blade. I have in the past on one of my other kits with this sort of rubbery type stuff. I've actually just brushed on a little bit of this Tamiya thinner, and it's pretty much got rid of a bit of the lines going back and forth on it, and I found that quite good. So you've obviously got to test it on something first, but I actually did quite like that, getting rid of those funny little mold lines on some of the little rubbery parts. But it's not too rubbery. It's not what like the Star Wars Revell sort of kits, if you know what I mean. If you've picked up one of their AT-RTs, or I'm not sure about their new speeder bike kits that they've got from one of the new movies, but it's a lot feels a lot more professional than that. Can't really stand those rubbery figures because they're very hard to paint, and once you paint them, if you start moving them, well, obviously the paint's going to break off. So I don't really understand the point in doing those figures like that. I know some of them are for kids and stuff like that, but I'm not a fan of them. Now, to try and roll around the head on this pen for you, and as you can see, there's quite nice detail on this. And as I said, guys, for the price. So if you're picking up something from else from probably Link Japan, I think whacking one of these in for that price is fantastic. You don't want to pay for postage on its own just for this one little kit, but if you're picking something else up, they're probably on eBay as well. Maybe even cheaper, I'm not sure. But anyway, guys, I just wanted to show you a quick little video on these because I don't know how much longer they're going to be around for. I mean, they've been around for 2014, I didn't even know about it. Just a very quick look at your Iron Man 1/24 scale model kit for a very cheap price. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.